Once you've captured all the information through the fitting process, you got to make sure that you can get it to your rider. So now we're going to teach you how to build the report at the end of the fit. We get to the report builder by clicking down on the icon at the bottom left of the screen. Some report elements are already checked as default. Cover page is always selected and cannot be deselected. The physical assessment default is also checked, but it can be deselected. This is useful when providing just a bike measurement report for a rider if you're not going through the entire fit process. Pre and post-fit ZINs, plus the ZIN and pose measurement definitions, need to be checked to be included in the report. A complete report following a retool fit should have both. There are some instances, like on a new bike purchase, where a pre-fit ZIN may not be necessary. At a minimum, the report absolutely needs to have the post-fit ZIN. The next line down is for adding the 3D bilateral poses that were taken during the fit. Since you probably took quite a few, click on the Add Bilateral Report button to select which poses will be included in the report. A new window will open with all the left and right poses that were captured during the fit. The most complete report will include a pre-fit and post-fit bilateral pose report. But all four cannot be selected at once. First, select the initial left and right poses and click Save. Another small window will pop up. Title the initial left and right poses Pre-Fit and click Save. The Pre-Fit Pose Report has been selected and will be in the report. Now click Add Bilateral Report again. Select the final poses. If they were not named final, choose the during number that represents the final captures from the fit. Click Save and name the final poses Post-Fit. Now both pre- and post-fit bilateral pose data will be included in the report, showing the rider how their body was aligned before and after the changes made during the fit. The next possible element of the report is adding still images taken from the webcam video recordings. There is a separate course for how to use the webcam to record video during the fit. Let's assume video and stills have already been captured. Click Add Snapshot Report to choose which images to include in the report. The window pops up with all the images that have been taken from the videos captured. The columns are listed as top and bottom snapshot. This is because two images can fit onto one page of the report. This function determines which is the top image and which is the bottom image on that page. A thorough snapshot report will include side and front images. At a minimum, include pre- and post-fit side view images. Select pre-fit front for the top and pre-fit side for the bottom and click Save. The pre-fit snapshot page is now included in the report. Click Add Snapshot Report again to add the post-fit images the same way. Select the front view for the top and the side view for the bottom again to be consistent with the previous page and click Save. And now there is an additional page included in the report that has the post-fit images. Select the ZIN and pose measurement definitions if the rider needs to have detailed descriptions that define the data included in each bike and body measurement in the report. Finally, move to the summary to add notes and recommendations from the fit. A, B, and C templates are edited in settings. Assume that we have already completed templates for A and B. Here I have clicked Load A, which inserts the template previously created in settings. From here, make the necessary edits and additions to the template text. If adding additional text by clicking Load B or C, there will be a prompt asking to overwrite or append. Overwrite will delete the existing text and replace it with the template chosen. Choose Append to add the other templated text to the end of the existing text. Here is an example B template, used to remind the customer, and maybe even more importantly, remind the fitter, of the adjustments or equipment that were suggested during the fit, but the rider chose not to go with that day. A completed fit summary from this customer's previous fits can be added by choosing Load Summary, which will open another window where the bike and fit session can be selected to find the summary to copy into this report. With all elements selected and the summary complete, the report is ready to be created. Click Create Report. A window will open to choose the place to save the PDF that will be created. The very first time the software creates a PDF, it will open a window to save the PDF to the desktop. Before saving, create a file folder on the desktop. After creating a Fit Reports folder, the system will default to the same place each time. Be sure to notice that the file name that automatically populates is the last one that was saved. If Save is quickly clicked, it will overwrite this new Fit Report over the last one saved. Be sure to create a new name for the Fit Report just created. I like to use the rider's name, bike model name, and the date. Then click Save. After clicking Save, a different window appears with a progress bar. Just be patient. Do not try to click anything while the report builder creates the PDF. Once complete, minimize V7. And then open the Fit Reports folder. Find the report and use your preferred email account to send a copy to the rider. Let me make one suggestion. Since all of your reports are going to be saved to the hard disk on the laptop or computer that you're using, I strongly encourage you to back up all of this documentation somewhere other than the laptop. Whether that be a Dropbox folder or another hard drive, make sure you've got copies of all this data saved somewhere else.